I remember lying down in the middle of the road and I'm like, I want to die like right now.
My father was murdered when I was 12 years old.
Do one thing that makes you want to throw up every single day.
Need motivation?
Watch a top 10 with Believe Nation.
What's up, Believe Nation? It's Evan. This channel is designed to be a part of your daily success routine and help you believe in your Michael Jordan level talent. So let's get your motivation to a 10 and get you believing in you. Grab a snack and chew in today's lessons from a man who went from having his alcoholic father killed when he was 12 to spending time in a French prison for smuggling drugs and then being homeless and broke for years to getting a $500,000 record deal and being an entrepreneur and motivational speaker. He's Garrain Jones and here's my take on his top 10 rules to success. Let's kick it off with rule number one, change your mindset.
When I was at rock bottom, I didn't know that I was at rock bottom. And you can't really change what you're not aware of. And so it was like one of those things where it's like, can it get any worse? Bam. Can it get any worse? Bam. And it just, I kept asking the question, can it get any worse? I didn't know that what I was asking was causing my life. So it was to the point where either I die or I do something about it, because it was like, I didn't have my daughter pretty much was like, you're not my father. You don't know what love is. My girlfriend had just broke up with me. And, you know, my mother was pretty much 16 different, she was on 16 different medications. There was so much stuff going on. And I'm watching all of these people be successful. And I'm like, I'm more talented than them, and I don't understand why I'm still in the exact same spot, which I didn't know was rock bottom. And then one day it just all came crashing down, and I was like, why am I here? I remember lying down in the middle of the road, and I'm like, I want to die, like, right now. And I stayed there. Cars were driving by, honking and everything. And I don't know what happened in between that. But literally, my car had just got out of the impound. My mom had paid for it. She didn't even have much money. But somehow, she would always do something for her baby boy. And she got my car out of the impound. The day I got my car out of the impound, that's when somebody had broke into my car. Like, and it was like, can it get any worse? And that night on La Brea, on the corner of La Brea and Hollywood, I'm at there's like this like little shopping center, and my car was parked, my window was busted out to the right, and literally it was raining. It was 3:43 in the morning, August 2011, and I yelled out, eyes bloodshot red, and I still didn't know that this was rock bottom, but I've always focused on what I don't want. And I just remember saying, Okay, I'm tired of fighting. I don't want to fight anymore. I want to be healthy. I want to be happy. I want to be surrounded by nothing but positive people. I just want to inspire people, and I want to make a bunch of money, but I want the money to represent something that I passionately believe in. Just show me a sign. Show me a sign. Show me. And I just kept saying it over and over and over. It wasn't until a week later until I met the man at the gas station, and he asked me for money. And he said, do you have any money? He's just like, it was a homeless guy. And I'm like, and he had a wad of money. I said, you have more money than me. And he goes, have you ever seen the movie Rain Man? The guy was talking to himself. Person did the exact same thing. He was like, change your mindset, change your life. Change your mindset, change your life. Change your mindset, change your life. Change your mindset. And then they walked away. And it was in that very moment I felt like my whole entire life was a lie.
Rule number two, get out of your comfort zone.
If you can imagine a little dog that goes in a neighbor's yard, and then the owner gets mad, so he puts this shock collar on the dog's neck. And then outside of the yard is this invisible wall, and as soon as the dog goes to the wall, it gets shocked. So guess what? Your parents say, don't touch the stove, you'll get hot. Bam,
shot. Don't run into the street or you'll get run over. Bam, shot. Cover in between the lines. Bam, shot. You do this, you'll get in trouble. Boom. Why? Turn on the news, you see all this crazy stuff going on. Shot, shot. You've been trained off of fear-based tactics your whole entire life. So what happens when the owner takes the leash off the dog's neck? It's already built subconsciously in his mind. Anywhere I get close to going past comfort zone, I pull back, even when the shock collar is not there. So when people go out on their own and they go to work for another person, they don't even realize that they don't have the shock collar on anymore. And that's why they say 9 out of 10 millionaires fail their way to success, because they took the most risks and they learned the most lessons. And from that, they showed other people how to do how they got to where they are. So everybody out there, you don't have a shock collar. That is an invisible wall of fear. And anytime you feel that knot come up, on the other side of that wall is called the door to more. Open it and watch your life change.
Rule number 3, be bold.
The reason why I'm coming to you today is simply to talk about something that has been holding mankind down for year after year after year after year after year. And that is fear. That is fear. Lack of this. I don't know how I'll ever be able to do it. How is that even possible? I don't think it's for me. I'm so afraid. Stop all of that. You were put on this earth to be a champion. You woke up this morning and that is your holiday, to be like, I am alive and that I'm in purpose, on purpose, and I'm here to deliver a message to the world. And whatever it is that you choose to focus on, to create with your thoughts and your energy, that is your message to the world. Would you want your message to the world be, oh, I can't stand traffic, or she makes me sick, or he makes me sick, or I don't know, is this for me? Is that what you want your message to the future generations, to know that that was your character? Heck no. We weren't put on this earth to pay bills and die and pass that philosophy on to our kids. We were put on this earth to be bold and live out loud and do something with our lives, impact the world, impact the community, do something, be brave, be bold. And exactly in direct proportion to how you approach the world is how it responds to you and your thoughts and your energy. And most people focus on the fear of failure rather than the possibility of gain. So I'm encouraging all of you out there, ladies and gentlemen, remove the fear of failure. Well, what if it doesn't work? Well, what if it does? Possibility of gain, gain time, gain friends, gain a business, gain financial freedom. Gain power, gain energy, not the failure. Remove that. Take it out of your thoughts. Take it out of your words. Take it out of your actions. Your actions. And how to change your life is simply do the opposite of whatever you normally do. And if anything is fear-based, you put a stranglehold on your future. Let's not focus on the fear of failure. Let's focus on the possibility of gain. Do one thing that makes you want to throw up every single day. What's the one thing? Whatever that is. Build the muscle. Build the new pattern that allows you to step into your life boldly. You do that, everything changes.
Rule number 4, do what you love.
So my whole entire life, I want to be a superhero. I want to be stronger than the average man, have abs like an action figure, and save people's lives all over the world. I maintained that all the way through high school. When people started giving up and started to go, I'm gonna go do what my dad is doing, I'm gonna go do with what my mom is doing. When it was time to graduate and all the stuff that you do to graduate, they're like, so what are you gonna be when you get in the real world? Tell me you still don't wanna be a superhero. And I'm like, I want to be stronger than the average man. I want to have abs like an action figure. And I want to save people's lives all over the world. And I was so serious. When I left that, that's when I was stuck. That's when I was lost. When I left everything that I loved to do as a child, that's when I said I felt like something is missing the most. I like to say that anything that you love as a child is connected to your inner child, which is directly connected to source. As soon as I started doing everything that I loved, there was a surge of power, a surge of confidence. I wasn't insecure anymore because the emotion that had the most dominance in my thought process and in my heart process was actually being paid attention to.
Rule number 5, commit fully.
But life cannot deny someone who gives their absolute all, but make sure you use your whole self. I'm not talking about kinda do this, kinda do that, kinda wake up, kinda show up, kinda do this. Anything you kinda do, you'll get a kinda result. But why do fish make it look so easy when they're swimming? They're flowing, because they use all of themselves. Birds, you look at them, they make it look so easy when they fly, because they use all of themselves. We don't use all of ourselves because we've been given the dignity of choice. I choose not to wake up. I choose not to go to this seminar, and I choose not to read this book, and I choose to read this gossip column and all this stuff poisoning your mind. You don't have a shot collar. You're free to do what you want. The day that you decide to take possession of your own mind, that's your declaration of independence.
Rule number 6, surround yourself with greatness.
Michael Jordan couldn't have won those championships by himself. He had a coach. Yeah, there's people around him. When I was never exposed to that kind of environment. Like, my father was murdered when I was 12 years old, and I had to experience that myself in person. So that's the kind of life that shaped and cultivated me. So I didn't know anything outside of the hood. But when I was around people who were like light bearers and world changers, and who actually just like, they weren't just saying, I want to change the planet. I'm changing the planet. This is what I'm doing. This is the result. This is the book that I'm reading. These are the seminars that I took. So just being around that environment, it was like a form of language. And I'll tell you really quick, the greatest way to learn, if you want to learn French, it's not at Coffee Bean doing Rosetta Stone. Go to France, eat a baguette, be around the French people, be around the culture. So when I was in that culture, by default, I just started shifting and compressing time frames.
Rule number 7, love no matter what.
What's the trait that you've cultivated in yourself that you think is most responsible for your success?
Honestly, the ability to love no matter what.
That is not what I expected you to say.
The ability to love no matter what, because I came from such a hateful environment, and I didn't know what was going on while I was in insecurity. I don't love myself. I have a high hairline. I'm going to be bald by the time I'm 20, and that's all I'm hearing, my slightly crooked nose. I don't love myself. I don't love my body, so I'm just eat all this food. Like, coming from that environment and then learning to love every aspect of myself, whether you like it or not, and just truly learning to love myself, and then being in a situation where I was in business with someone that had a very similar path and very similar growth of success, but it seemed like something was holding us both down. And I remember one day we were going on a retreat, and I looked in the mirror and I said, you know what? Him being a friend to me has nothing to do with me being a friend to him. So I'm just gonna love no matter what. And I remember saying that, and something leaped out of my chest. It was like this weird, thick, and I felt light. I felt very different. Now that day I posted, and this is before I was getting thousands of likes and thousands of shares. That day I posted something on Facebook. I tagged maybe 48 people and got maybe 30 something likes. That's when nobody was messing with your boy. And that weekend when we went on that trip, I was like, you know, him being a friend of me has nothing to do with me being a friend of him. So I'm just going to love no matter what. And I'm just going, no one state, no one, I will never give anyone else permission to change who I am. And when I just made that decision to love no matter what, even if you hurt me, I know deep down inside that that's not really you. And just to come from the place of loving no matter what and really being able to accept people for who they are, how they are, and how they are not without any expectation whatsoever. 3 days later, I went on Facebook and I posted the exact same message, but I didn't tag anybody, but I felt different. Feeling is the secret. I felt different where I was coming from, saying the exact same thing. I posted and it was like 475 likes, like within like an hour. I'm like, what the hell happened? I was speaking to my life coach at the time, Monica Zanz, and she was like, well, what did you do different? I was like, well, I had this conversation. She was like, you released hate from your heart. And that was the grip hold that you had, resentment. Like what it takes to hold on. Remember I told you, we're not created to be keepers. We're created to be givers. You and I, we can't hold that water. It's got to come out. Can't hold like all that stuff you hold on to. And I was holding on to resentment. But the power that it takes to hold on to resentment is the same power that's needed to sustain at the next level. And I didn't even know that I was holding on to the universe of the next level inside of that resentment. When I let that go, anything that I was a part of tripled within 3 months. And people are like, what are you doing? I was, the only thing I did was just like release the resentment that was inside.
Rule number 8, do something different.
Every single day that we wake up, we have been gifted the opportunity of choice. You can choose to be happy or you can choose to be sad. I don't care what your situation is. You should never allow your situation to define who you are as a person. I know I lived out of my car for 2.5 years. And you know the story that I told myself in my head every day, all day long? Why does this person get this? Why does this always keep happening to me? Why do I keep getting this girlfriend, this kind of girlfriend? Why does this happen to me? How come this person got this record deal and I didn't? How come this person, why? Oh, poor pity me. Shut up, Garrain Jones. The outside is the physical manifestation of what goes on inside the brain. Things do not just happen. No one just rear-ends your car. You don't just become broke. Broke is a mindset. Things don't just happen. Your pocketbook is not just below balance or on zero. You're not just overweight. Things don't just happen. I wasn't just living out of my car for 2.5 years. The outside is the physical manifestation of what goes on inside the brain. Just like you can think yourself sad or mad or broke and all of these things, you can also think yourself happy. I'm telling you, coming from a guy that lived out of his car for 2.5 years, I have stuff that I haven't even posted online day one, day two, day three, day four, day month, like month, year. It was so bad that I was numb with emotion, numb with emotions, crying myself to sleep in my Jeep. How does a guy with so much passion live in his car for 2.5 years? It was all because of me. I deserved to live in my car. I deserved to be broke. I deserved not to have the opportunities that I should have been getting. And they weren't for me. But I'll tell you what was for me. I woke up every day with an opportunity to choose different. If you want something different, you have to do something different. It's that simple. You want something different in life, You have to do something different.
Rule number 9, persevere.
As we know, we hear these transformational stories and there's a common thread through all of them, yeah. Right? So what is that common thread, do you think?
The common thread is perseverance. Like me, I've always wanted to be a superhero. By the way, I am. I'm stronger than the average man. I have abs like an action figure, and I save people's lives all over the world, but I've been saying that since I was 4. And then when you see, you know, I've interviewed lots of people who, the major influencers, I call them power influencers, and they have very similar stories. On the surface, it's different. Like, you didn't have to live in your car for 2.5 years to be in a relationship where you felt trapped for 2.5 years. It's all the same. Right. You know, but there's perseverance and there's the willingness to get back up, have that grit, keep going no matter what.
And rule number 10, the last one before a very special bonus clip, is have fun.
What do you mean? When you nod your head yes, but you wanna say no, what do you mean? Hey, yeah. When you don't want me to move, but you tell me to go, what do you mean? Oh, what do you mean? Since you're running out of time, what do you mean? Oh, 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 what do you mean? Better make up your mind, what do you mean?
Now I've got a really special bonus clip from Garrain on how to put the puzzle pieces back together, but before that, it's time for the 3-point landing question. It's time to move from just watching another video to actually taking some kind of action in your life or business. So here we go. Number 1, what's the biggest mindset change that you need to make? Number 2, what are you going to do to boldly make that change happen? And number 3, what do you need to surround yourself with to make that change stick?
Most people don't know how they got to where they are because they were born into an environment to where they had no control. Mom and dad, all of a sudden you start doing what mom does, doing what dad does, doing what your teacher does, doing what your friend does, doing what your grandparents do, and every single person that's come in contact with you has literally influenced you away from how you came into this world. So to answer your question, my greatest accomplishment is being able to figure out how to put all the pieces to the puzzle back together so that people can have a blueprint on how to live life, how they came into this life. Because you're born with a perfect puzzle piece. And every single thing that has ever happened to you in life, you scatter the pieces. Now your job as an adult is put all those pieces back together.
Raise your standard.
Apple, at the core, its core value is that we believe that people with passion can change the world for the better.
Not one drop of my self-worth depends on your acceptance of me.
If you guys want to continue to learn how to change your mindset, I highly recommend the Tom Bilyeu Top 10 Rules of Success. I've linked it up next to me. Go check it out. Continue to believe, and I'll see you there.
Do whatever you need to do to remind yourself, only execution matters.